Welcome back. For this tutorial, we're going to cover the selection tool, which by default is selected when you start a new model or load a new model from the file menu. So the selection tool, if it's not already selected, you just click on it, left click on it in the tool ribbon. Now when you have the selection tool activated, clicking on any geometry will select that geometry. So for example, I can click on a point to select a point, I can click on an edge, it'll just select that edge on the face, etc. Then I could perform some operation with the selected geometry. Now oftentimes, of course, we want to select more than one piece of geometry, so in that case I just hold down the control key and left click on whatever I want to add to the selection. Now another very important skill with the selection tool is the triple click. So if I click on any of these surfaces, of course it will just select the one surface, but if I triple click, it will select everything that surface is attached to. So in this case, that entire solid. If I triple click on this, of course it grabs that solid. So that's a fast and quick way to select entire solid objects. One thing I should point out, another way to select entire objects is to just click on them in the structure tree, and that's another way of grabbing them. So, you know, early on in one of the first lessons, I showed you how to do, you know, basic selection in SpaceClaim, you know, using the box select, either left to right, right to left. But sometimes, you know we want to select a number of features that share similar properties. So for example, you know, I want to remove all of these grooves. Now I could go through, I could, you know, control click, you know, each surface. Of course, that's going to be very time consuming. But I could, you know, box select it. So for example, let me see if I can get a good angle here. You know, I can start my left to right box select here. In that case, you know, I was able to grab it all in one go, but then I'll have to go over here and I'll have to, you know, hold control, do another box select and hope that I don't catch any other geometry. And so you can do it that way, but there's a much more sort of efficient or time-saving method if, you know, you're trying to select a number of features that are similar, and that is using the power select tools. So for example, if I click over here on the structure tree, you'll notice down at the bottom you can change the view to a number of different there's a number of different tabs here. So I'm going to click on the selection tab, and now it gets rid of my structure tree, and now I see the selection panel. And there's a drop-down box here with a number of types of features or, you know, properties that you can look for example, rounds. I'm just going to leave it at all types because that's going to give me the most sort of number of options. And then what I do is I just, you know, click on one of the features I want to remove. So I know I want to remove this groove, so I'm going to select, you know, I'm going to select all of the faces in that groove. Again, I could use a box select to just get that one. It doesn't really matter. So we make that selection, and now you'll notice over here there's a number of options. Now if I hover over all coincident faces, for example, it finds all coincident faces. So I could click on that, but you'll notice, you know, it only captures sort of these. It doesn't capture the face on either side of the groove. So instead, maybe I'll click on faces with same area. So it finds all of these faces that have the same area. And then I can hold down control, click on another one. So it'll grab all the side faces that are the same area. And then finally, I'm going to click on this one. And so it finds all of the, you know, all the faces in that groove. It'll find all other faces with the same dimensions or same area. And then now I'm just gonna zoom out to make sure that it has in fact selected everything and that it hasn't selected anything that I don't want, because maybe, you know, there just happens to be another face in the model that happens to match one of the size of one of those faces. So I'm just gonna check to make sure it looks pretty good. Now I'm just gonna hit the F key on the keyboard for fill, And there, it's got rid of all of those features. So you can, it doesn't just work with, square faces. Obviously, you can also look for example, rounds. So if I click on this round here, you'll notice now I go over here in the selection panel, there's a number of options. Again, I'm just going to drag this down so we can see them all. See everything in one without having to scroll down. So again, if you had things color coded, you could find all faces with the same color and remove all of those faces with the same area. But because it's a round, we actually have some special options exclusive to rounds. So for example, I can find all rounds are equal to the same size. Or perhaps, there's all these other rounds and I know that I want to get rid of everything. So I can select all rounds equal to or smaller than the selected round. So I click on that. Now it's grabbed all of those rounds and I can hit F again. And now it's going to remove all of those rounds. Now, I know from before there was an issue with this round. It wasn't able to get rid of it because there were some geometry issues. So I will have to go in, and manually fix that, manually get rid of those rounds. But for the most part, it did removed all of the rounds that it could, barring any, weird geometrical issues. So now if I want to, for example, maybe I want to get rid of this cylinder here, or all of the sort of coincident cylinders. I could click on one of those cylinders. Now you'll notice it finds all coaxial cylinders, or I can just click on all coaxial cylinders and I hit F. It'll try to do its best. It wasn't able to remove those, so I'm going to try that again with a different, search pattern. Equal radius protrusion faces the same area. I'm going to select coaxial surfaces. So now I see that it's grabbed all of the sort of surfaces that are coaxial, and I'm just going to hit F, and that got rid of them. So that's pretty much power select in a nutshell. So I hope that was helpful. Thank you very much for watching.